special thank you to two people, Raging Rabbit 24 and Tony Tostada. Thank you so much to both of you for the super thanks and the tip. I really appreciate it, and it's very helpful for me. I'm actually thinking of getting a new mic, so
to be a counterweight.
toxic positivity when I started writing them. I have bipolar disorder and ADHD and probably other stuff buried beneath those two behemoths. I've always felt a bit disconnected from the regular world. I've lived with severe depression and anxiety and unpredictable mood swings for most of my life, so I'm very familiar with the darkness of feeling completely alone. And yet, I'm far from alone, something that took me years to see. I was just one of many, many, many who felt the same exact things. It took most of my life, but I finally learned how to feel less alone. And part of that was peering into the darkness and learning how to understand it and over time live with it. I did that by writing about it and eventually sharing it with the world in the hopes of reaching others who feel like I do. And nothing takes the power away from a fear like looking at it straight on, especially seeing it in type in a serene photographic setting. Fun fact, I took all the photographs for the disappointing affirmations myself on vacations with my then wife. Little did I know at the time that they would be the idyllic backgrounds for these little necessary moments of acknowledging thoughts that so many of us share and that feel important to recognize and yes, to laugh at, making light by shining. Okay, now back to wishing everything was different. My sister.